How's it going everyone? Shifty here and I'm back with another Destiny 2 video. With our first Iron Banner since the release of Beyond Light, we are once again met with a reprised set of armor as well as two old Iron Banner weapons, now with random rolls. One of the new weapons is a 120 RPM hand cannon called the Steady Hand, and the other weapon is a high impact scout called Guiding Light. Now, different weapons to chase is great and all, and there are definitely good rolls for both of the returning weapons. But since the buff to 120 RPM hand cannons, I can't help but recommend the Crimil's Dagger. This is a hand cannon that was reintroduced in Season of Arrivals. I'm going to go over some of the good perks as well as a particular god roll that I have and that you'll see me use in the highlights a little bit later. Before I get into the video, if you end up enjoying it or finding it useful, make sure to like and subscribe. I'd love to have you join my channel. Also, if you want to further support my channel, hit up my Amazon affiliate links in the description down below. If you plan to shop on Amazon anyway, you can use those links and help out my channel at the same time. Anyway, let's talk about Crimil's Dagger. I know there are some who like True Prophecy or the Steady Hand better, but I really enjoy how this particular weapon feels. As for potential god roll perks in PvP, you want Hit Mark, Crossfire, or Sure Shot HCS in the first column. Then in the second column, I would recommend Accurized Rounds or Tactical Mag. Then the third column has several good choices, but I would go with Moving Target or Rangefinder, especially if you're going to be using a hand cannon reload mod. If not, you could also go with Outlaw. Then in the final column, you got Kill Clip, Opening Shot, or Explosive Payload that are all great options. Given the buff that came with Beyond Light, I had to dust an old one off that I had sitting in the vault. Let's just say after using it, I was not disappointed. The perks I have on mine are Fast Draw HCS, which I had to settle for considering I didn't get one of the three that I recommended. Then I have Tactical Mag, Moving Target, and Opening Shot. To add to this, I have a Range Masterwork, and I threw a Targeting Adjuster mod on it as well. As you may have guessed, with the accuracy and aim assist boost, this thing feels extremely sticky. Hitting headshots is a breeze, and its optimal range is quite impressive. Also, if you didn't know, if an opposing guardian has 4 resilience or lower, 120s can kill them in 1 crit and 2 body. That's extremely forgiving, especially given the amazing range on these weapons. Any guardian above 4 resilience requires 2 crits and 1 body, which is still pretty forgiving. Anyway, there is one more thing I wanted to bring up. With both the Charged with Light setup and the Whisper of Hedrons, you can get pretty frequent 2 taps with this weapon. Anyway, let's check out the potential of Crimil's Dagger with some of my PvP highlights. Stick around for the last set of highlights to see how great the Shadebinder Warlock still is in PvP.
Thank you. has a